A suspect now in custody for a hit-and-run crash that killed a man who was doing yard work.
Police arrested 42-year-old George Van Blyenburg on Sunday. He's accused of hitting and killing 42-year-old Brandon Kishida, who is trimming the grass alongside Aiea Heights Drive.
Bridget Namata follows up. Bridget.
Marissa Dash, we spoke with neighbors in the area who say dangerous driving is something they see every day. I also learned the driver who's now in custody has had several traffic run-ins spanning nearly 20 years. Flowers placed alongside Aiea Heights Drive for Brandon Kishida, who lost his life Saturday afternoon after he was hit by a vehicle while doing yard work for an elderly person. Aiea resident Vicki Wagner says speeding on Aiea Heights Drive is common, but Kishida was hit by a car traveling up the hill.
How do you not see somebody in the day unless you are distracted?
Further down the road from where Kishida was hit, I noticed that there is a school zone. So I'm going to talk to the bus drivers to find out what they see on a daily basis. So when you found out about the deadly hit and run, were you surprised?
No. I knew it was going to happen one way or another, sooner or later.
Why?
Because right before the guy got banged, there's a bus stop that I used to drop my kid off from school. And even with our stop signs out, they would overtake you. And the ones coming out, because I like park kind of like on an angle so that he has, you know, more leadway to go, they'd overtake the stop sign. So it was an accident waiting to happen.
I asked Major Darren Izumo if police would consider stepping up enforcement in the area.
That's certainly something that we can check on in light of this.
I also asked about George Van Blyenburg, who was arrested Sunday in connection to the hit and run.
The first thing that comes to mind is that, people, if they are involved in some kind of collision, are required both morally and legally to remain at the scene.
We did some digging and learned Van Blyenburg has received speeding tickets and a ticket for running or not stopping at a red light. Would you consider this a case of distracted driving?
Right now, it's still under investigation, but that's a good point to bring up that a lot of our collisions have to deal with, and they all start with D. There's drunk driving, drugged driving, drowsy drivers, distracted driving, and an add-on to me is like dangerous or dumb drivers, people that speed, do dangerous maneuvers. So at this point, we're not sure which, if any, or all of these were factors.
Van Blyenburg hasn't been charged yet. He is facing negligent homicide and failure to render aid charges, a Class B felony punishable by up to 10 years in prison. Bridget Namata, KHON 2 News.